Hi, I'm Jamin, and today I'm going to help you with a section on understanding intervals. There's basically three parts to today's lesson. We're going to talk about the names of the intervals, the types of the intervals, and then at the end I'm going to explain to you why those are the names and the types. So let's get started. So an interval is just the distance between two notes. So for example, from here to here, that's a minor third. That minor third is the name of that interval, the distance between that note and that note. From here to here is called an octave. That's the name of the interval. So interval is just the distance between two notes. To find out the name and type of the interval, first what we need to do is find out what those letters are called. So in the first example I gave you, from here, that's an A up to C. This is a type of a third because there's basically three letters are involved, A, B, and C. That's what that interval spans, the letters that interval spans. So right here, from A up to C, that's a type of a third. If we were going from A up to D, that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4. It'd be some type of a fourth because A, B, C, and D are all involved. If we're going from A all the way up to A, all we do is count the letters in between. So we go A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. So that's an eighth of some kind. An eighth has a special name. It's called an octave. But that's how we find the name of the interval. Just count the letters that are involved in it. This next part's a little bit more tricky. This is finding the type of interval that we have. So we found out that in order to find the name of the interval, we find out what letters are involved, and we count those. To find the type, actually, there's two separate categories. There's those intervals that can be called perfect and those that can't be called perfect. The perfect intervals are ones, fours, fives, and eights. So if we have, for example, from here up to here, that's a fourth of some kind, because it's A, B, C, D. So that's a fourth of some kind, and that is in the category of possibly perfect. However, the seconds, for example, are not able to be perfect. So we have some options for major intervals. Either they can be called major or minor or diminished or augmented. In the category of perfect intervals, we either have perfect, augmented, or diminished. Those are our options. So if it's perfect, it can be one of those three. If it's major, it could be one of four. Let's start with the perfect intervals. Now, from A up to D, we've already discussed, is a fourth because A, B, C, D, that includes four letters. Now, this one right here is actually a perfect fourth because it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 half steps away. So from here to here is 5 half steps. Whenever you have a fourth and it's 5 half steps from the previous note, it's always a perfect fourth. So another example of this would be like D up to G. That is a fourth because D, E, F, G, there are four letters that are involved, and it's a perfect fourth because it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 half steps away. So here's what happens. A perfect fourth is 5 half steps. However, if we increase the size of the interval by, for example, going from a D to a G sharp, now the interval is larger. It's 6 half steps from here. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's 6 half steps now, but it's still a fourth because of the letters. It's going from a D up to a G of some kind. So as long as we have a D up to a G of some kind, it's still a fourth, but in this case, it's larger than a perfect fourth. It's augmented. This would be an augmented fourth. In the same way, if we take that same fourth and we make it smaller by a half step, we can either do that by going from D up to G flat, and now this interval is smaller than it originally was, or we can go D sharp up to G. This is also smaller than the original perfect fourth. Now it's this size, 1, 2, 3, 4 half steps. This one's a diminished fourth. So the perfect category can either be perfect, or if you make it larger, it can be augmented, or if you take a perfect interval and you make it smaller somehow, then it's diminished. The non-perfect intervals work almost the exact same way. So let's use sixths, for example. If we go from C up to A, that's going to be a sixth because C, D, E, F, G, A. So we've got six letters involved. This is some type of a sixth. This one actually right here is a major sixth. Now, if we make this interval larger by going from C up to, for example, A sharp, it's still a sixth because we're going from a C of some kind to an A of some kind. However, this one is larger than the major interval, so this one is augmented. This one right here is a major sixth, again, because this interval, as your chart shows you, is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 half steps away. And whenever you have a sixth that's 9 half steps in size, it's a major sixth. If it's 10 half steps, it's augmented. 9 and it's major. If you make it 8 by making that smaller, or you can make it 8 by raising this one from a C sharp to an A, then it's a minor sixth. So this is a minor sixth right here, C sharp up to A. It's a sixth because it's going from C to A, and it's minor because it's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 half steps away. This last part's a little bit tricky, so follow with me here. If we use that same one, the sixth, this one was the major one. If we make it smaller by, let's say, lowering that A to an A flat, it's still a C up to an A, so it's still a sixth of some kind, but it's a minor sixth. Now, if we take this one, and instead of it being A flat, we go down to this note. I know it looks like a G, but if we call it an A double flat, because this would be A, A flat, and A double flat, then this is technically an A of some kind, if we're calling it an A double flat. So from here up to here has to be some kind of sixth, because it's an A, or it's a C up to an A, even though it doesn't look like it. In this case, this one is called a diminished sixth. Because remember, this one up to the A was a major sixth, then a minor sixth is smaller than that. Now if we go from C up to A double flat, that's a diminished sixth. More commonly, it would be like a C sharp up to an A flat. And that still kind of looks like a fifth, but because it's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 half steps away, it's a diminished sixth if we're calling this a C of some kind and calling this an A of some kind. Now, there are literally entire books about the theory behind intervals, but I just want to show you briefly kind of how we come up with the names for these. So if we take a major scale from, for example, C up to C, or C down to C, that's a major scale. So if we're in C and we start on C and we go up a second, which would be C to the next D that's in the scale, which is this one right here, you'll notice that that is 2 half steps away. 1, 2. However, if we go from C down a second, from C down to B, you can see that's only 1 half step because there's no black note in between. So this is a half step in between these. So as it turns out, when we go up, we end up with major intervals, and when we go down, we come up with minor intervals. So C up to D is 2 half steps, C down to B is 1 half step. So we say that if your second has 2 half steps, it's a major interval, and if your second has only 1 half step, it's a minor interval. Same thing happens on the third. If we go up from here, up a third, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 half steps. If we go down a third, we're only going to have 3. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, this is the minor third, and this is the major third. The one that has 1, 2, 3, 4 half steps in it is the major. The one that only has 3 half steps is the minor. Now, perhaps you're wondering about the perfect intervals. How come some are perfect, some are not perfect? Let me show you. If we go from here up a fourth, we end up right here. If we go up the scale, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 half steps. However, if we go down the scale from here to here, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 half steps. So the perfect intervals are the intervals that are the same distance whether you're going up the scale or going down the scale. From 1 up to 4, or from C up to F, is the same exact distance as C down to G. So those are perfect intervals because going in both directions, it's 5 half steps. Same thing for the fifths. If we go here up a fifth, we come up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 half steps. If we go down a fifth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 half steps. So those are perfect. The fourths, up a fourth, down a fourth, and the fifths, up a fifth, down a fifth. Same thing for the octaves. From here, from this C to that C is the exact same distance as from this C down to that C. So that's why the eighths are also perfect. So fourths are perfect, fifths are perfect, octaves or eighths are perfect. The other one that's perfect is ones, or they're called unisons, which is the exact same note. From C all the way up to C is the same distance as C all the way down to C, because in either direction, it's the same exact note. So unisons are perfect. Fourths are perfect. Fifths are perfect. And eighths are perfect, because it doesn't matter which direction you go, it's going to be the same distance either way. So that's it. All you got to do is count up the letters that are involved and then find out how many half steps there are in between each note. If you use your chart, you should be able to find the name of any interval. Thanks a lot. Good luck. Have fun.